the Major General, late Major General Robert Adenka Adebayo. So it's really going to be one event that if you're there, you definitely don't want to miss this. You want to be a part of it. It is in many ways historic, not just for the people of Ekiti State, but the western region, the southwest geopolitical zone as it's known now, and of course Nigeria as a whole, as we have many people from all walks of life, eminent personalities from all parts of the country who are there to pay their huge respect, their last respect to this great Nigerian, the late Major General Robert Adenka Adebayo. Of the funeral service of the late Major General Robert Adeyinka Adebayo. The procession moving gradually to the Adebayo family compound there in Imiokuti for the interment and the burial ceremony. That's the final burial for the late Major General Adebayo, former governor of the old Western region. I did say earlier that part of some of the things that he was able to do while he served as the military governor of the whole Western region. Remarkably, as governor, he promoted the agricultural extension services in particular, and the establishment of the Institute of Agricultural Research and Training, known as the Moore Plantation in Ibadan, Oyo State. That was one of the great achievements of his administration there. Of course, he also was able to resolve peacefully the farmers, the infamous farmers revolt over taxation back in the 1970s, the mid-70s, I believe, where farmers were so unhappy with the way they were being taxed, known as the Agbekoya revolt. Then he waded into the crisis to resolve the matter. All right, we're seeing live pictures now. They have a military guard, a brigade guard there, the compound, waiting to receive the body of the late Major General Robert Adeyinka Adebayo. You can see there from the live feed, the live pictures, the long convoy, as it were, for the late Major General, having families, I'm sure guests, special dignitaries, captains of industry, you know, eminent personalities, people from all walks of life who came there to grace this occasion. First of all, it was the church service, which ended a while ago, and now they will be heading to his family compound for the final burial of the late Major General Adebayo. So, a man of many parts, a man who really believed in the oneness of Nigeria, a man who believed that education, as we will understand, was so committed to ensuring that many of Nigeria's youth, children, not just while he served as military governor, even up to this present time, he strongly believed that the greatest legacy, of course, that you can give to any Nigerian is education. He strongly believed in it, and it is indeed one of the many things that he saw as a way to really emancipate the people, you know, to keep them developed in the quest of socio-economic development. And you just can't rule it out for someone who really believed in that. And he in fact made sure that even his own children, as we heard from his son, the governor, former governor of Ekiti State, Nia Adebayo, that he really believed that every child must receive qualitative education in order to achieve great things in life, not just for himself or herself, but for the community and the nation as a whole. So, say we see pictures there where the late Major General will be laid to rest eventually, and then also the Brigade of Guards there, military officers, are also waiting. The motorcade